Yes, sir.
Now, okay. What is concurrency testing?
Concurrency. I not heard about it.
So concurrency testing is you know one of the name of multi-user testing, multiple user testing. Let's say if a particular application has been accessed by a single user, so that is single user testing. But in case of concurrency testing, what would happen? There will be multiple users who will try to access that application at the same time to verify the effect on the code or that particular feature or module or what is happening with the database when so many people are trying to access. Okay, so database should not get locked or it should not undergo the deadlock situations into the code. So that is known as concurrency testing. So generally, if you will see applications that are used within the banking domain, like Citibank is there or Wells Fargo Bank is there. So they'll do concurrency testing before releasing the software because so many users will be using the application at one particular time, right? So that is
multiple users trying to access like concurrency in a concurrency testing.
Absolutely. Yeah. Multiple users will try to make sure that the database is not getting locked and database is accepting all the values of all the various users. Then again, the concurrency testing is also taken place at the different time zone locations. Okay. So what is data-driven testing?
Data-driven testing is basically data is taken from the external, data is taken from suppose Excel file, etc. Code will be heavy, execution will be so slowly. So we use the data-driven testing. We take on the data from the external files.
Mm-hmm. Right. And that file can be a text file, it can be an Excel file, it can be an XML-based
CSV file.
Okay. Yes. Now, which are the fields that keep a data when you are filing a bug into the defect management tool?
I didn't get question.
Okay. So what are the different fields in a bug report? Or let's say if you're logging the defect into a defect management. Yeah. So which are the different fields in that?
So first one is project name, then module name, sub-module name. Mm-hmm. Then defect ID is there, then version number is there, then also severity of that bug, priority of that bug, assigned by, then reported by, and a screenshot, if there is any screenshot or any information regarding to that bug, which are the component of the defect.
And then you'll also have a unique ID, then prerequisite conditions should be there, like test steps are there. Yes. Severity, priority, I think you mentioned already.
Yes.
Okay. Now consider you are given a particular application or a feature to be tested by your test manager or your test lead, but there is no any documentation done or you are not having any requirement specifications available for that particular feature to be tested. So how will you overcome this challenge?
Firstly, I try to connect with my seniors or my leads and try to get information regarding that, having a knowledge of the person. And then explore the application randomly to know the features and functionality.
Anything else you would like to add?
Understand the requirement. Yes, sir.
Okay. So you gave a right answer to some extent. You will be coordinating with your test managers and test leads, but you also have to collaborate with the business analyst and the developers who have developed the application, or the business analyst who have got the requirement from the customer, or who was on a call or was in a scheduled meeting with the client. Okay, so though so those people will give you the right inputs, and then you can basically take the screenshots and try to create a document with the flow of the application. Okay, let's say first login is happening, then what is the happy path? Okay, then which are the various error conditions or system conditions that are taking place into the application? So what are the different validation messages you are getting? Then you can also refer the previous version of the same application or software. What was the behavior into the previous earlier version of the software? Okay.
Yes.
Then you can also look into the defect management tool and try to understand the defects that the earlier version had, which were the defects that were logged by the testing team. Okay. So their expected result will tell you the behaviors of the application.
Yes, sir.
Now consider you have to test a particular YouTube video. So what all things you will test with respect to video and the audio? So can you tell me the test scenarios?
Yes, sir. We check the resolution of that video.
Mm-hmm.
Then the video is properly audible or not. Then user able to on the video, sir, you are asking test scenarios.
Yeah. So any normal videos are there? Let's say you are watching a video of software testing on YouTube channel. Okay, on any YouTube channel.
So we can verify with. Without internet connectivity, without internet connectivity, how it is responding? Like and dislike buttons also there. We check that user able to like video or dislike video. Yes, okay.
So first of all, the very first thing that you will check is the access levels. Okay, if any particular video is restricted to some users, then only those users should be able to watch that video. Okay, next is different kind of environments. Okay, you can then next is browser compatibility. You can check in you can check in Google Chrome, you can check in Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay, screen resolutions is one of the scenario that you already mentioned. Internet connection speeds, 2G, 3G, 4G on a mobile router, how it is, is it audible, it is properly, viewed, a user can easily view it. Okay, then video by the size, what is the size of the video? Okay, then there are different options like play, stop, mute, pause. Yeah, downloading of that video. Okay.
Yes.
Then likes, dislikes, and comments to that video should be, tested. Then interface with the social networking websites. Like, let's say if I want to share it on the Instagram, Facebook, it should be easily done.
Yes.
Then what is the buffering speed of that video? And let's say if I want to embed that video into some particular HTML website, then that should be taken care.
Also skip video option is there.
Also skip video.
Option is there.
Yeah, very nice. Okay, so these are the whole and soul scenarios of the testing a video, or whether it is audible or whether it is. Okay, Snehal, I'm done with the interview. Do you have any questions for me?
Yes, sir.